All right, there, Sean McYorkie here, once again bringing you my humble opinion, where I take a glance at the games on the monthly Humble Choice bundle. In this case, from February 2024, we have Beacon Pines, a cute looking game. Let's see what it plays like.
Dear reader, allow me to introduce you to my book. Though it might at first appear like many books you've come across, it is far from ordinary. You may, therefore, have some misunderstandings about its nature. The story that awaits you has not been fully told. In fact, its conclusion is not yet known, even to myself. It is in that way that my book is special. It is in that way that you are special. Without you, there is no story. Chapter 1. Normal isn't what it used to be.
Yeah, that one.
This is a story about change. Nestled in a shallow valley is the town of Beacon Pines.
Okay.
Far from the town square, across the river, past the neglected welcome sign, a young boy walks alone at dawn. His name is Luca Van Horn, and like you, dear reader, he's here for a reason.
I have to walk up there. Hey, Dad. How are things going? Today's the first day of summer vacation. I start middle school next year, I guess. I was 6 years old when you died. And it's been 6 years now. From here on out, you'll have been gone longer than you were here. Feels like that should mean something. Mum always said that this tree was your favourite spot in the world. Wait, 12 years old? Starting middle school? Me too. Hey, Luca. I knew I'd find you here.
Mama was Luca's closest friend. He possessed many fine qualities, but subtlety was not one of them.
Well, after I banged on your door till your gran answered, and after I checked the pond and climbed the treehouse, then I knew I'd find you here.
Mama finally noticed the tears welling in his friend's eyes and the flowers on the grave.
Oh, yeah. You and your mum always did this on your dad's birthday. Yeah. I didn't know if you were going to keep doing that, now that your mum's gone too. She's not gone. She's just missing. Sorry, I meant to say since she went missing. She's going to come back, Rolo. Of course she is. Wait, does that mean he's 12 and looking after himself? Okay, Dad, see you next time. Think I'm ready to get out of here. I don't like the nonsense. I've never liked that in games, but that's me. The music is almost aggressively pleasant, but it is pleasant. And the graphics are cute AF. So I'll lead the way. Tickle. Okay. What's that? Is that a sticker or something?
Wonderful! I had a good feeling about you from the moment you opened my book. That charm is a very special thing.
Okay.
Very special indeed. Keep hold of it for now. Its purpose will reveal itself soon enough.
So I guess... Is there a point to clearing all these, I wonder? Might be. Oh, they're growing back, so no. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. The whole reason I was looking for you. I was wondering if you'd get to that. I found the perfect way to start out summer. How's that?
Rolo looked to the side suspiciously.
Not here. They might be watching. They who? Shh, not so loud. We need to do this in a secure location. Mission Control. Alright. I just have to ask the living room, and then we can head out. What are you going to tell her? I don't know, I'll think of something. If it's all the same with you, I'll meet you at the welcome sign. Your gran still kind of weaks me out. Why, what's wrong with gran? I don't do well with new people. She moved in like half a year ago. Oh, it's him. Just meet me at the sign when you're done. Oh, it might be him, it might be gran. Suit yourself, I won't be long. Tell gran before heading out with Rollo. Okay, so we have a mission. I've got to go to that. Okay. Make me look at it first, and then I can go in.
Dear reader, forgive me for this interlude. Remember that charm you found in the dandelion patch?
Yeah.
There are more of those special charms to discover throughout Beacon Pines. They've been known to reveal themselves to those who are willing. Some of them can be found in this very house.
Okay. Time to explore then, I guess.
Since Gran had moved in, the house was more peaceful, more orderly, and more covered in flowery fabric.
Wasn't a charm, though, was it? We've got a chair to lounge in. And ponder! Oh, this is so bloody cute.
Gran had already lit the fire. She kept a warm house, as if by grandmotherly obligation.
I can't read the books or anything, okay.
One of his father's old stethoscopes. Luca had spent countless hours listening to anything and everything with it. Not for years, though.
Oh no, we've already done that. Get off of there. Well, the grandfather clock. Nope. That's the exit over there, so that's probably not. Nothing with them.
Just some dusty knickknacks.
What about...
An array of prepared meals crowded the refrigerator, each labeled with the day of the week.
The voiceover was nice. I wished it was all voiced, but it's an indie game, you can't expect everything. Alright.
A pair of dull scissors, a broken can opener, a mostly empty bottle of glue, and some loose string.
We got junk!
Piece of furniture Gran had brought when she moved in was an old hutch.
A hutch? Okay, is that what we're calling it? That's fine. I'm sure it's a valid term for it, I've just not heard that one before.
Oh my, this is quite exciting. I am now certain that you are the one I've been waiting for all these years.
Why?
You'll recall I was a bit coy regarding the use of charms earlier.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I tend to have a flair for the dramatic. You are about to encounter your first turning point.
Okay.
There are certain times in this tale when everything hinges on a single word. Ooh. Step forth, dear reader.
Okay.
A sturdy old wheelbarrow.
I'm actually going to go inside
again. On the
again.
Other hand, I suppose there's no reason to rush things.
No.
Gran will be waiting when you return.
Exactly. That's what I figured. So I want to go upstairs first, see what's up there. There might be other things up there.
Gran had commandeered the upstairs closet when she moved in. Some things need shelter from a young boy's mischief. She...
Hide! See? I found one! I shouldn't be so excited.
Luca paused at his parents' bedroom door. He just wasn't ready to go in yet.
Okay. Ah, there's a door there, that's why. Ah, this must be Luca's room.
Luca tossed on his favorite old sweater. Even though it was the first day of summer, a chill still hung in the air.
We found another one.
Gran's moving in meant that most of Luca's things had been crammed in the corner. Luca was somewhat annoyed by the situation. Gran's bed was undisturbed. Luca didn't mind that she had a habit of falling asleep in front of the fireplace. It meant that he could read late into the night.
Okay, so they shared a room. Odd, but not wrong. That looks like that might be it for things we can discover in here. Time to go speak to Gran then. Hang on, is there anything at the bedside cabinet? No. There's no speed up, it looks like. There's a jump. Spacey jump. Right, now, let's just wander around the garden before we go speak to Gran.
Young Luca would spend hours hiding in the bushes, waiting for a chance to jump out and startle his mother. She always enjoyed humoring him by feigning terror.
You put her into an early grave, didn't you, you bugger? Oh no, she's missing, not dead.
A beginner's guide to gardening laid open on the bench.
Okay. Go up there. Nothing there. Hey, Gran, I'm gonna go hang with Rollo for the day. See you later. Hold up now. Where are you and Rollo headed exactly? Oh, nowhere special. We're just gonna go hard for the day. I can do ponder, hide, or chill. Let's chill.
We were just gonna go chill for the day. The best lies are built on truth.
You boys are always in a hurry to do nothing. Yeah, we're busy doing nothing, working the whole day through. Trying to find lots of things not to do. We stick to what we're good at. We'll make sure you're done chilling in time for supper. There you go.
Impressive. You've managed to navigate your first turning point without too much of a mess. That is the power of charms. A single word can change everything. I think it's time to introduce you to the Chronicle.
What, a newspaper? Okay, B.
The Chronicle is a record of the decisions you've made.
Ah.
You can see the turning point, which has been revealed. At any time, you can use the Chronicle to go back and invoke different charms, creating new branches. Luckily for us, this is the one and only turning point where the charms won't dramatically alter fate. It's the perfect opportunity to experiment with rewriting things.
I could ponder, but I'm not going to rewrite right now. I'm going to do chill.
We were just going to go chill for the day.
There we go.
The best lies are built on truth.
So we've seen that. And I could have changed what happened there.
Easy.
Right, let's get out. I didn't want to change that one. Oh, and Luca? You and Rollo stay out of trouble. Yeah, I've got a lot of doubt about that. I know. Get into trouble with Luca. Yeah, with Rollo, rather. I don't think there's anything else here. No. Right. That is a curious mechanic. An interesting one, not a bad one. Come on. Ooh. Dang it, Rollo.
For a town that saw few visitors, the welcome was perhaps more grand than necessary.
You know the drill. Don't let anyone discover our secret path.
Chapter 2.
Alright, I would normally go about 30 minutes with one of these, but I'm going to stop there with this one. And it's for a specific reason. This is a story form game that I really... it's so freaking charming, I'm really attracted to the game. And so I don't want to spoil it for if I run it on channel later. I don't know if this will be tempting for people to watch. If so, let me know. I'll see what kind of interest there is for this and maybe bring it. I might even just put it up for votes, like, you know, for Tales of Coffee, things like that. But this is so freaking charming. The music I'll give a 7. It does the job quite nicely, but it's a bit aggressively nice. The sound effects I'll give a 6. They're not doing more than doing the job. The world. Oh, the graphics. I'm going to give a 9, surprisingly. I know it's not everyone's cup of tea. But the charming, cute nature of it is so perfect for this kid-like game. It's beautiful. It really is beautiful. Gameplay. It's a story form game, so you can't expect deep gameplay. But it does have a couple of mechanics, like the finding of the charms, rewriting the story, the chronicle, the actual exploration of the world, etc. For this kind of game, I'll give it an 8. The storyline so far is simplistic, almost naive, but so charming in that it's really good. It's heartwarming almost. I'm sure disaster's gonna hit, but it's so cute, and I'm gonna give it an 8. Whether you like that or not, I don't know. This is so off for me that I can't believe I'm so enjoying this. It really is enjoyable. It's cute as hell. Was it worth $1.50? Does it pay for its slot in the Humble Bundle? Yes. Is it worth $12? I absolutely think it is. $12 plus. You know, it pays for the whole Humble Bundle. And will I play this anymore? I think there's a decent chance I will. There are a lot of games to play, so I don't know for sure. But it's got a real attraction to it. Now, if there's a call for it to come to channel, it will definitely get played again. If not, I'll probably play it for myself at some point. So, join us next time.